become a great group leader, I think it's a very difficult issue. It's called the Peter's Principle, as far as I know. So you become a group leader because you are very good in doing experiments and thinking about in a way that experiments have a higher chance of being a success. And then you go to a position where you're not necessarily good at.
You know, I like being a postdoc a lot, and so I thought being a research fellow would just be like being a postdoc, and so I was a little bit, hadn't really thought about the more practical and organisational parts of being a group leader. So one thing I wish someone had told me actually is how hard the first few years of being a group leader is, because you have to be your best postdoc, your group leader and a lab technician and maybe a couple of other jobs as well.
To my opinion, the prospect of being group leader begins when you are still a postdoc. And probably at the end of your postdoc, you have to, you know, force yourself of thinking behind your postdoc and what you're going to do afterwards. And find, you know, a new niche or, you know, new topic to discover. And obviously, there's the other critical thing is to find money to set up your own lab. And so if you are, you know, higher in the best university in the world with a huge amount of startup packages, that's relatively easy. But not every university in the world has a huge startup package. And in the university I choose to go, actually, there was no startup package at all.
So, but this question of environment is important, right? One could choose the best university in the world with lots of money, but this might not be the best place, A, to do your science, and B, to be authentic again. Exactly. So finding the right environment, finding the right colleagues, finding the right research equipment that can help you is also critical, right?
Certainly, yes.
So what would you advise PhD students, postdocs? I think the first advice, if you ask me, is that they have to realize one important thing. That you cannot be a group leader in a 9-to-5 job.
So then maybe this point relates to my piece of advice, which is about finding something that you love and that you want to know the answer, more or less independent of 9-to-5. I mean, it has to be, I completely agree. So if you love it and you care about it, then you commit to it, and then that doesn't matter anymore. Yeah.
The advice of not working 9-to-5 is totally true for the group leader, but it's totally true also for the postdoc and for the PhD student. Yeah. Science is all about dedication and works.
On the other hand, science is really cool. I mean, as I said, it's a hobby for me personally. Mm-hmm. You meet very interesting people. It's exciting, especially in the biomedical area nowadays, because it's exploding. It's beautiful to be part of it.
I fully agree with you that it's cool, but unfortunately, it's not everybody. Every day, very cool. And there's days that are extremely frustrated.
Sure.
And I think science is also a huge resistance to the frustrations.
So they should be prepared for that.
Yes.
Yeah. So, but maybe a career in science is like it's like any relationship. It will not be perfect all the time. The ups and the downs will be there, and sometimes the downs will be extremely low, but the highs will be extremely high. Yeah. And the pleasure of discovery is the thing that keeps us going, I think.